Greetings of the day. Today we shall talk about Shakespeare's famous sonnet, "Shall I compare thee to a summer's day?" "Shall I compare thee to a summer's day?" is one of the most popular sonnets of William Shakespeare. The text of the poem is thus: "Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's lease hath all too short a date. Sometime too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often is his gold complexion dimmed, and every fair from fair sometimes declines. By chance or nature's changing course untrimmed, but thy eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose possession of that fair thou owest, nor shall death brag thou wanderest in his shade, when in eternal lines to time thou growest, so long as men can breathe or eyes can see, so long lives this, and this gives life to thee." The summary of this poem is, the orator begins the poem with a question addressed to the patron or the beloved: "Shall I compare thee to a summer's day?" He is pondering over the correctness of his comparison. The next 11 lines are devoted to such a comparison. In line 1, the speaker specifies what primarily distinguishes the young man from the summer's day. He says that he is more lovely and more temperate. Summer's day inclined towards extravagances. They are traumatized by rough winds in them. The sun, which he calls the eye of heaven, often shines too hot or too dim, and summer is momentary. Its date is too short, and it leads to the withering of autumn, as every fair from fair sometime declines, meaning thereby everything comes to an end, howsoever beautiful or precious it might be. The final quatrain of the sonnet tells how the orator differs from the summer in this respect: "His beauty will last forever. Thy eternal summer shall not fade and never die." In the couplet, the speaker explains how the beloved's beauty will accomplish this achievement and not decease because it is well maintained in the eyes that can see. This hyperbolic statement is very impressive. This rhyme is certainly the most famed in the long series of Shakespeare's sonnets. It may be the most famous poem in English. Putting all his words together, among Shakespeare's works, only lines such as "to be or not to be" and "Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou Romeo" are better known. This is not to say that it is at all the best or most fascinating or most beautiful of the sonnets, but the straightforwardness and beauty of its praise of the beloved has guaranteed its place in the history of poem writing. On the exterior, the poem is merely a declaration of admiration about the beauty of the beloved. Summer tends to hostile extremes of windiness and heat, but the beloved is always mild and pleasant. She is beautiful, and if it is a male, then he is beautiful. Summer is, by the way, embodied as the eye of heaven with its gold complexion. The description throughout is simple and natural, with the darling birds of May giving way to eternal summer, which the reciter promises the beloved. The language too is comparatively simple for sonnets. It is not weighty with alliteration or assonance, and nearly every line is its own independent clause. Almost every line ends with some punctuation which effects a pause. This makes it very easy to understand, and this is the very caliber of Shakespeare, that he makes things very simple to understand. This sonnet is the first rhyme, the speaker's first effort to retain the young man's beauty for all time. An important theme of the sonnet, as it is an important theme throughout much of the sequence, is the control of the speaker's poem to the challenge time and last forever, carrying the beauty of the beloved down to future generations. The beloved's eternal summer shall not fade, precisely because it is embodied in the sonnet. Here, Shakespeare is very confident that his sonnet will be eternal. That is why he says, "So long as men can breathe or eyes can see," the speaker writes in the couplet, "so long lives this, and this gives life to thee." This hyperbolic expression is the landmark style of Shakespearean sonnets. His intense sense of loyalty and praise to his patron or beloved makes the sonnet appealing to the reader and the audience. That is the reason why this sonnet has gained a lot of approval from readers as well as critics. For students, the basic words that need to be understood in context with the poem and its meaning. The word thee and thou stand for you. The word art, A-R-T, art, stands for are, A-R-E-R. The word temperate means modest. Rough means harsh. Lease here stands for time span, the time that life has given to us. Date here means time. It is not the date which we understand, the date of a calendar, but here it stands symbolically for time. Eye of heaven stands for the sun. every fair stands for all forms of beauty, because beauty has many dimensions and it is very difficult to contain beauty in a single form. So it stands for every form and every dimension of beauty. The word decline stands for degeneration. Here, Shakespeare has used the word untrimmed, which means here reduced or deprived or bereft. The word eternal stands for everlasting. The word brag stands for boast. To say something superfluous about a particular thing. So, Sheikh, if you understand these words properly, the poem is very easy to understand. And if you understand this poem, it is one of the greatest creation in the history of poetry. Thank you.